Hi, thanks for listening. As we all know, black people can't be racist. So I wanted to show you an example of a black person not being racist, right? Because they can't be. It brought to my attention on Facebook, right? And there's this artist, and his name's Alex L. Art, right? That's his name, right? And he just does, as I say, does a lot of artwork and makes it public for everybody to see, so fair dues to him, that's his business. Anyway, there's this particular one I saw, and even though black people can't be racist, obviously, because they don't have any power, the same way white people can't be thieves, because we do have all the power, so only black people can be thieves, but white people can't. Stupid, isn't it? Anyway, even though black people can't be racist, this drawing that this guy done, and he's a black guy, by the way, is without a doubt one of the most racist things I've ever seen, right? not even joking, ever in my life, man. Anyway, I'll put a picture of it up and I'll describe it as I go, right? Here's a picture of it here, right? Now, as you can see, it's a black man and a black woman in the middle of the picture, and both of them are kicking people away out the picture, right? The black man, he's kicking a Chinese man out the picture, you know? And the black woman, she's kicking what looks like either a Korean or a Hispanic out the picture. It says at the top, if the community is going to get better, first things first, we need to stop our dependence on foreign resources. That's what the top it says. And then they've got speech bubbles, the two characters. The black man, he's saying to the Chinese man, right, he's saying, the decades of you leeching off of us has come to an end. Sell that grease in your own community. Get out, big letters, you know, 3 exclamation marks just to get the point across. He's saying that to the Chinese man. He's kicking out of the neighbourhood. And he's standing on, like, an out-of-business sign on Lee Wong's, right? So he's put them out of business and kick them out of the community, right, for leeching off of black people, right? The black woman, she's kicking, well, as I say, what looks like either a Korean or an Hispanic. It's out of business, Kim's Beauty Supplies, so I'm just guessing it's Korean, right? Maybe I'm wrong. But anyway, she's saying to the woman that she's kicking away, you've done enough damage selling us WHD, which I think is supposed to mean white. You've done enough damage selling us white beauty standards. I've got my own hair. I don't need yours. Get out. Again, 3 big exclamation marks, capital letters, right? Now, when I saw that, I thought immediately, wow, that is one of the most racist things I've ever seen in my life. I'm not even joking. That is just so fucking racist. It is unbelievable. But it's not only racist, it's fucking pig ignorant, right? And actually laughable, right? But I don't want to come across as a racist here, right? But I may step over that line at some point here, because this just winds me up. Anyway, the guy who put this up has put a little description next to the photograph, right? And here's what the description says. All I see around my neighbourhood is Asian and Hispanic people who own these stores. The laundromat, nail salons, beauty stores, Chinese stores and corner markets. They come to our community and take our money and do absolutely nothing to contribute. Bunch of leeches, get out. Just picture it. Me going to Chinatown trying to sell soul food. I'd be boycotted out with the quickness. Whatever. Let's get our ish together. Which I think is supposed to mean, let's get our shit together. You know, illiteracy means that happens. But anyway, back to the picture, right? Let's have a fucking look at this a wee bit further, right? We need to stop our dependence on foreign resources, right? Well, first of all, the Chinese man in the, I'm going to say Hispanic or Korean. I'm going to say Korean, right? Because the name's Kim, so I'm going to say Korean, right? So the Chinese man and the Korean, they're probably in America legally, and therefore they're not foreigners, as it were. Anyway, the black man, which is the funniest of all, it really is. The black man says to the Chinese man, the decades of you leeching off of us, right? Now let's take a look at that, eh? Let's take a look at that. See, when the Chinese man is in the black neighbourhood with a Chinese restaurant, he is not leeching off of anybody. And the nerve, oh, the fucking nervous is what I mean. I don't want to step over the line, but there is a certain group, and I won't mention them, I'm sure you can guess, but there's a certain group who are well known for fucking leeching. But anyway, this black man is kicking him out and calling him a leech. A leech. He's not a leech, it's called supply and demand. What he's doing is he's supplying a service, and when... sell that grease in your own community. You're not forced to buy that grease. If you don't want it, don't buy it. It's that simple. And if people in your neighbourhood didn't buy that grease, the shop wouldn't fucking be there. It's supply and demand. It wouldn't fucking be there. It's a legal business. He's got every fucking right to own a business wherever the fuck he wants, as long as he's paying his taxes and filling out the correct fucking papers and all that shit. But this is absolutely unbelievably fucking racist. Unbelievably racist. And then we go over to the fucking woman, the black fucking Beyonce, like, you know, oh, you've done enough damage selling us white beauty standards. White beauty standards that you were not forced to buy. Nobody put a fucking gun to your head and said you must dress and look like this. Fuck sake. I've got my own hair, I don't need yours. Exactly. Don't buy it then. Don't go into the shop then. Go somewhere else. Fucking hell. But either way, that woman's still got a fucking right to own a fucking business, whatever the fuck she wants, as long as she's doing it legally. Fucking hell, man. Anyway, one of the most racist things I've ever fucking witnessed in my entire life. I'm not even joking, man. The fucking nerve as well. The nerve. And then let's go on to what he says. All I see around my neighbourhood is Asian and Hispanic people who own these stores, the laundromat, blah, 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 right? Now, they come to our community and take our money and do absolutely nothing to contribute. Again, he calls them a bunch of leeches, get out. But again, they don't come to your community and take your money. They come to your community and they earn your money. And the money you give them, you're getting a service in return. They're not taking anything from you. They're not stealing from you. And they're not leeching off of you at all. They're actually being clever and running a business. That's what they're doing. They're not in any way fucking leeching off anybody. And you say, they do absolutely nothing to contribute. Yes, they do. They pay fucking taxes. They don't owe you personally jack squat. They don't fucking come up to you and give you money, you stupid cunt. They pay fucking taxes like every other business, and that's how they fucking... That's why they're legal and they've got every fucking right to be there. You racist bastard. Just picture it. Me going to Chinatown trying to sell soul food, right? You wouldn't be boycotted out. That's not what would happen. What would happen is you'd be removed from the area because nobody in Chinatown would fucking buy soul food. You moron. You have to use your fucking intelligence. It's location, location, location. That's the rule. You don't want my soul food restaurant in Chinatown, you fucking moron. What the fuck would you want to do that for, you clown? Jesus Christ, the reason they open Chinese restaurants everywhere is because everybody loves Chinese food. Fucking hell. If they didn't, they wouldn't open them everywhere, would they? Fuck's sake, man. But there's another point I wanted to make, right? And this is, again, I feel I have to apologise because I might sound like a bit of a racist here, but there's something I want to say. I'm in Scotland. I'm a fucking white guy in Scotland, and I can see that this is happening in America, and this is what I wanted to say, right? You see, when it comes to the Koreans, the Chinese, Hispanics, and the whites with businesses in black areas, right? The reason they've got businesses in black areas and black people don't is because when a black man educates himself, starts his own business, or chooses to work his way up in a company, right? He's not told, good man, well done, you're setting a good example. There's a role model to the kids. They're not told that. What they're told is, nigga, is you crazy? You're fucking Uncle Tom, Oreo cookie. You're acting white. You're a white lover. All that fucking bullshit. What kind of black man wants to run a business surrounded by people who are going to fucking treat him like that? Fuck off. It's absolutely unbelievable. Black people hold themselves back. That's why it's not black people running these businesses. Nobody's stopping you except your fucking self. Oh, it winds me up. But see, I'll get called a racist for saying that, but I'm just being honest. And as I say, I'm away across the fucking water, and I can see that this is happening. I don't know how they can't see it themselves. It pisses me off. But I was going to make the comparison, say, imagine that was two white people in the picture kicking any other race out, but I shouldn't have to make that comparison. This is bad enough. But it's not only racist, it's inciting racial hatred and it's inciting racial violence. If it was two white people in that cartoon kicking any other race out of their neighbourhood saying the same shit about them, that it wouldn't last fucking 5 minutes on Facebook. It'd be taken down because it'd be seen as fucking upsetting racial groups. It's absolutely unbelievable. I'll leave a link to the fucking thing, but it doesn't let you comment. He's clicked the comments off in the fucking photo, so I can't even let him know what I think. Oh, anyway, I'll leave it there for now. Thank you for listening. Until next time. And he's a black guy, by the way. Is without a doubt one of the most racist things I've ever seen. Right? not even joking. Ever in my life, man. Anyway, I'll put a picture of it up and I'll describe it as I go. Right? Here's a picture of it here, right? Now, as you can see, it's a black man and a black woman in the middle of the picture. And both of them are kicking people away out the picture, right? The black man, he's kicking a Chinese man out the picture, you know. And the black woman, she's kicking what looks like either a Korean or a Hispanic out the picture. It says at the top, if the community is going to get better, first things first, we need to stop our dependence on foreign resources. That's what the top it says. And then they've got... Hi, thanks for listening. As we all know, black people can't be racist. So I wanted to show you an example of a black person not being racist, right? Because they can't be. It was brought to my attention on Facebook, right? And there's this artist, and his name's Alex L. Art, right? That's his name, right? And he just does, as I say, does a lot of artwork and makes it public for everybody to see, so... Fair dues to him, that's his business. Anyway, there's this particular one I saw, and even though black people can't be racist, obviously, because they don't have any power, the same way white people can't be thieves, because we do have all the power, so only black people can be thieves, but white people can't. Stupid, isn't it? Anyway, even though black people can't be racist, this drawing that this guy done, I see around my neighbourhood is Asian and Hispanic people who own these stores. The laundromat, nail salons, I think I mean salons, beauty stores, Chinese stores and corner markets. They come to our community and take our money and do absolutely nothing to contribute. Bunch of leeches, get out. Just picture it, me going to Chinatown trying to sell soul food. I'd be boycotted out with the quickness, whatever. Let's get our ish together, which I think is supposed to mean let's get our shit together, you know, illiteracy means that happens. But anyway, back to the picture, right, let's have a fucking look at this a wee bit further, right. We need to stop our dependence on foreign resources, right. Well, first of all, the Chinese man in the, I'm going to say, speech bubbles, the two characters, the black man, he's saying, To the Chinese man, right, he's saying, the decades of you leeching off of us has come to an end. Sell that grease in your own community. Get out, big letters, you know, 3 exclamation marks just to get the point across. He's saying that to the Chinese man, he's kicking out of the neighbourhood. And he's standing on, like, an out-of-business sign on Lee Wong's, right, so he's... Put them out of business and kick them out of the community, right, for leeching off of black people, right. The black woman, she's kicking, well, as I say, what looks like either a Korean or an Hispanic. It's out of business, Kim's Beauty Supplies, so I'm just guessing it's Korean, right, maybe I'm wrong. But anyway, she's saying to the woman that she's kicking away, you've done enough damage selling us WHD, which I think is supposed to mean white. You've done enough damage selling us white beauty standards. I've got my own hair, I don't need yours. Get out. Again, 3 big exclamation marks, capital letters, right? Now, when I saw that, I thought immediately, wow, that is one of the most racist things I've ever seen in my life. I'm not even joking, that is just so fucking racist, it is unbelievable. But it's not only racist, it's fucking pig ignorant, right? And actually laughable, right? But I don't want to come across as a racist here, right? But I may step over that line at some point here because this just winds me up. Anyway, the guy who put this up has put a little description next to the photograph, right? And here's what the description says. All